Today I'm going to talk a little bit more generally about musical instruments rather than play anything in particular, because I've been playing the guitar for about 30 years or so, and I have a sense, I think that I've now developed some sort of sense that I can talk about instruments in a general manner, in a way that might inform a new entrant into music, especially the guitar, and maybe influencing some of their decisions about what kind of instruments to play, what kind of styles of music to play, and their development as a musician generally. This is my first guitar. It's an acoustic guitar. This instrument is probably manufactured in the early 80s, and it was manufactured in Japan. It's a very reliable, solid, well-made instrument, and it was fairly inexpensive. In fact, in the 80s, if you can find a guitar made in Japan in the 80s, it's almost definitely worth more than what you'll pay for it today, even. They tend to be underpriced. They tend to be underappreciated. They're high-quality instruments, and they were produced in large numbers, so there's lots of them available. In Canada, you can get a 1980s Japanese-made guitar pretty well anywhere, and you're going to get a good instrument. I mean, a legitimately good instrument in every way. It'll last a long time. Its tone qualities are good. It's well-constructed in all key respects. This is a 30-year-old guitar with very little service or work on it. It's got very good action, more or less. It could require a little bit of fixing around the edges, but it basically works great and will continue to work great for a long time. Now, one of the differences between an acoustic guitar and electric guitar is the acoustic guitar has to generate its sound on its own, where an electric guitar generates it through an amplifier. So this is an electric guitar. By itself, without plugging it in, there's no sound comes out of this instrument. That's what we know that. Everybody knows that. But there ends up being some important differences between the instruments in terms of their construction and how they work as a result of this key difference. One, it's an amplified sound, self-amplified in terms of an acoustic guitar. The other one, it's externally amplified through a speaker and amplifier and so on. An electric guitar, for example, has a lot of flexibility in tone built into it. Because you're using an amplifier and using pickups to basically pick up the vibration of the strings and then translate that over to a speaker and amplifier, you have lots of options in the wiring of this system and the wiring of the amplifier and all the tone controls and knobs to get lots of different tones out of it. You can pick which pickup, you can alter which pickup you're getting, which is doing the work in terms of picking up the sound, the vibrations of the string, and that affects the tone quality. You've got tone controls in the instrument itself that affects tone quality. You have mountains of flexibility. And that's why electric guitars in many ways are very easy to distinguish from each other. Players are even. Eddie Van Halen has got a distinct sound. He's got a distinct guitar, distinct settings, and it's unmistakable even if he plays the exact same series of notes as another musician. It's often quite easy to identify Eddie Van Halen because he's got such a distinctive tone. Stratocasters are very easy to identify by and large. If people are playing them clean, you're pretty easily identified. Same goes with these shorter scale length guitars like a Les Paul or a knockoff or a Gibson Les Paul, which this is, by the way. So electric guitars have lots of tone variability built into them. Acoustic guitars have virtually none built into them. They're very inflexible instruments in terms of what the tone controls are. You have to generate tone yourself. You've got to generate it by changing where you play. Are you playing over the sound hole? You can get one type of sound there. Or you're playing it closer to the bridge. Notice how the tone changes? That's a way to get tone. Another way is, depending on how you hold your pick, if you hold a pick, you can play fingers yourselves without a pick, or you can play with a pick. You get different tones that way. But even how you hold a pick generates a very different tone, and much more noticeable in an acoustic guitar than electric. If you hold it very tight to your finger, you'll get lots of pinched harmonics, lots of kind of extra sounds. Hear that little tone, that little... That little pinched harmonic is something that you can get an electric guitar too, but with an acoustic guitar, that's all you have to work with. It's all self-generated tone. Now, some people plug acoustic guitars in, and they have equalizers and tone controls and so on, but I'm talking about an authentic acoustic guitar. Because an acoustic guitar takes a lot more work, if you're trying to get tone, interesting tone out of an acoustic guitar, it takes work. You got to work at it. It makes it a more difficult instrument to play. Every acoustic instrument is, by and large, in my view, harder to master and harder to play than its electric equivalent for that reason alone. Everything else is similar in many respects, but that tone issue, it makes them more difficult because you've got to work at it. Another difference is that electric guitars tend to be constructed so they're easier to play for other reasons as well. They often have, if you look at the distance between the strings and the fretboard, it tends to be closer, so they have the action is a little bit easier, I guess that's the way I'd say it, than an acoustic guitar, although some very well-made acoustic guitars have really easy action too. But an acoustic guitar, you trade off something by having easy action. In my experience, if the action is too light, it doesn't have as much tone opportunities or range. One of the advantages of having a guitar with poor action, at least in my experience, is that you get a little bit more flexibility or creativity in terms of the tone you generate. So those are two big differences. Beyond the technical differences of an acoustic and electric guitar, one of the big differences, I think, is your control over tone. And that an acoustic guitar, it's harder to generate and control and manipulate the tone of the instrument. So superficially, it would seem that the acoustic guitar is a poor choice for somebody starting out with a guitar. Why not start with something that's easier to play with? And the answer, I think, to that question is, the reason why you should start with an acoustic instead of an electric, in my view, is that although it's harder to generate different tone, if you can do something in acoustic, you can always do it in the electric, but it does not work the same way, the other way around. So if you master this instrument, you can translate everything you learn over to an electric, but it's a lot harder to translate things you learn in an electric into an acoustic. And in fact, in general, if you only play an electric guitar, the acoustic guitar is going to seem, you're going to have difficulty appreciating it to some degree. You're going to view it as a more limited instrument, and it will take too much work for you to really develop a mastery of an acoustic guitar if you start with an electric. It's much better to start with an acoustic. It's much better to really learn about tone and all those things in acoustic guitar. And another thing, there's lots of other little subtle differences that follow that same theme, that an acoustic guitar is a little bit harder and an electric guitar is a little bit easier. So it's beyond just tone. Lots of things work this way. I mean, having to learn about how to play out of tune, for example. Acoustic guitars, if you've got an acoustic guitar that's over 10, 20, 30 years old, it's going to have some warping that's going to make it a difficult instrument to play as far as the intonation of the instrument is concerned. It's hard to get perfect intonation in an acoustic guitar, and most guitar manufacturers don't even take it enough into account. Intonation has to do with basically the thickness of the string, the length of the string, and the notes you're playing, and so on, and the tuning of it. It's related to the tuning of it, beyond just the tuning pegs. An electric guitar is very easy. Intonation is very easy to set up perfectly because you've got each string, you've got control over the length of the string by changing where these little saddles, these little electric guitar saddles are. You move them forward or back to correct the intonation. An acoustic guitar, you can't do that. You're stuck with the instrument. And again, that seems superficially limiting. Well, it means you've got to work a little bit harder. You might have to learn how to play your individual instrument a little bit differently. You might learn that there's certain places that you can play on it and certain places you can't. Otherwise, the intonation's bad. You might find that certain keys are better to play in than others on your instrument, especially older instruments, that it sounds great in E, but it sounds terrible in C because of intonation issues. And you might also have to learn how to bend your strings a little bit while you're playing, because maybe it's in tune when they're open. This is kind of in tune. But when you play up here, they're not really in tune to each other anymore, so you have to bend them a little bit when you're playing to correct for that intonation problem. Again, superficially, you could say, well, that's a problem. It makes it a nuisance instrument. It's inferior in some ways. And maybe cosmetically that's true, but if you can figure it out, the electric guitar is a breeze. If you can figure that out, it's a breeze. It's nothing. Playing an electric guitar is nothing compared to an acoustic. If you can play an acoustic instrument well, you can play an electric instrument well, and you'll be good at it. You'll have stronger fingers because, of course, the gauges, the strings are generally heavier on an acoustic than an electric. The bends, if you can bend in a heavier string on an acoustic guitar, you'll have no difficulty bending in an electric. It's easy. There's nothing to it. Any monkey can bend a guitar on electric once you've mastered the basics of the instrument. So I guess what I'm saying is, if you're starting out and you're thinking about, what should I do? Should I play the acoustic or should I play the electric? And when you pick up an electric and acoustic, you immediately find the acoustic, man, it's harder to play. It's harder on my fingers. It's heavier to play. I got to press down harder. And all that stuff that makes it inconvenient is what makes it the better instrument to play. I'd say universally, frankly, I don't care for electric guitars that much. I much prefer acoustic instruments. I think It's just a personal taste issue. It's not because they're fundamentally better. There's a lot of great things with electric instruments, but it's my personal taste. But I really genuinely think it's a better instrument to learn on. It gives you a lot more range and flexibility. So there you go.